Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Our case today very interesting. Today's old boy, late preterm, 36 weeks, infant of diabetic mother, admitted to NICU due to respiratory distress. Tachypnea and retraction. Tachypnea RR 66 cycle per minute and oxygen saturation 92. Impression, late preterm, 36 weeks, infant of diabetic mother, RDS, to rule out early onset neonatal sepsis. So, plan of the care, septicolic uptake, and started ampicillin gentamicin, and the baby connected to nasopharyngeal CPAP, beep 7 cm water, and FiO2 oxygen 30%. Chest X-ray taken, consistent with RDS. Low or small lung volume, bilateral ground glass appearance, and the peripheral air bronchogram. Blood gas, pH 7.25 and BCO2 56, bicarb 18. Currently, after 2 days from nasopharyngeal CPAP, baby clinically stable, no retraction, RR 50 cycle per minute, and oxygen saturation maintained 99% on FiO2 oxygen 21%, blood gas pH 7.3 and BCO2 40 and bicarb 20. So the baby now ready to shift from nasal or nasopharyngeal CPAP, non-invasive ventilation, to nasal cannula 2 liter per minute FiO2 oxygen 21%. So the key points, the message from this case, what is the indication to initiate CPAP in late preterm 36 weeks if the baby having spontaneous breathing but labor depressing, or there is difficult breathing and heart rate more than 100 beats per minute. So this is indication to start CPAP or oxygenation ventilation support. The second key point, indication for shifting the baby from CPAP or non-invasive to invasive conventional mechanical ventilation. Clinically, the baby having respiratory distress, working hard, the kidney grunting and respiratory failure, apnea and cyanosis. Laboratory, the blood gas showed respiratory acidosis. The third key point, indication to shift the baby from nasopharyngeal CPAP to nasal cannula. Clinically, the baby doesn't have retraction or respiratory stress, and laboratory the blood gas appropriate or acceptable. ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا، سلام عليكم.